Well, we welcome you here this morning. Come in, Miss Lara. We started without you.
Norman and I were both wondering who it was. You knew it weren't me.
Well, we are glad that you're here this morning for our Christmas music and for this wonderful day of celebration. And the choir is going to be in just shortly, any moment. But we do welcome you here this morning, and we're glad that you're here. And if you're visiting with us, you're not just a visitor. You're our warmly welcome guest, and we are delighted that you're here. And if you're here for the first time, or for the first time in a long time, would you please look there in the pew pocket in front of you and reach in and get a visitor's card and fill that out and drop that in the offering plate as it goes by. And again, we welcome you. Let's pray together. Oh God, we thank you for this day that we come to celebrate and rejoice and give thanks for the birth of the Christ child, and as we lift our hearts and voices in song and in praise and adoration to you. We pray, oh God, that you would receive our worship as a sweet-smelling savor, that you would forgive us of all of those sins and transgressions that keep us and separate us out from you and keep us from fully and truly worshiping you in full relationship. So we pray, oh God, your blessings on this day for each thing that's done and said. We give you honor and glory and praise in Jesus' name. Amen. So if you would, look in your hymn book again. And if you would, let's sing together, Come Thou Long Expected Jesus, stanzas, the first and the last stanza, number 244. There are just a couple of things that I want to mention to you very quickly. Play practice has been moved up this afternoon to 2 p.m., so please mark that make sure you remember that. After the service this morning, we're going to step out on the outside just for about 10 minutes and simulate a time capsule burial. Actually, it is not a good morning for any kind of burial, but let alone a time capsule. So we're going to have to go through the service, but we're going to put the capsule away until it's a drier day. Then I want to remind you that Wednesday evening, 9 lessons and carols. Please do not miss this. This is a wonderful, beautiful old Christmas celebration that goes back probably 5 or 6 centuries. And it's a beautiful Christmas service. It really can be the very heart of Christmas if you'll come and join us for the scriptures readings of the Christmas story and the old carols that we sing together. Please come on Wednesday evening for 9 lessons and carols. And then the children's play next Sunday night, and also their sign-up sheets in the vestibule for desserts for our Christmas Day lunch for our guests who will be here. As well, there are some name sheets in the back, and the ushers have those. If you have names of folks that we need to contact and invite to our Christmas Day lunch. So all of that, if you have questions about that, check our website or ask after the service. And we thank you very much. All right, ushers. Would you pray with us, please? Oh God, we just thank you today for this opportunity to give back a portion of that which you've given to us. We thank you, Lord, that you bless us and bestow on us so much riches in this country. We ask that you bless us in Jesus' name and for his sake. Amen. And in just a moment, we're going to begin our Christmas music. But before we do that, just very quickly, there is another announcement that I need to make to you. I wanted to read this card. First of all, it has come this week, and it's from the Baptist Children's Home. You know that we have been taking donations for the Mile of Pennies and for other items for Baptist Children's Homes. Our white Christmas gifts went to Baptist Children's Homes, and they send the card. They say, Merry Christmas with the warmth of home and family. Fill your Christmas, and we thank God for you at Providence. Your support and love have brought love and hope and joy to the lives of our children. Brian Balsall and the Kennedy Home staff, thank you very much. God's blessings on you this Christmas season. And as well, I received a card this morning from the Danny Taylor family, and they just want to share that they have had just a blessed year and wanted to share some of that blessing, and there's a donation inside. Wanted to share that with the less fortunate in our community through our church family this season. And as well, just a reminder to those of you who plan to serve at the Christmas Day lunch on Christmas Day, there is a meeting for us this afternoon at 5:30. For those who plan to serve and be runners for the Christmas Day lunch, if you would try to meet with us for just a moment this afternoon at 5:30. And also the post office. If you have not checked your stuff in your letters, your cards in the post office, please go back to the post office sometime this morning or today, or the church will be open most all day, I think. And at other times, if you'll just go by and check that post office in your box to get your cards out as well. We just want to say that for many of us, this coming Wednesday will be a day of remembrance. Our dear friend, Miss Adrienne Carroll, passed away 3 years ago this coming Wednesday, December the 18th. And these beautiful, beautiful flowers are given in her memory this morning by Gina McLam and her granddaughter Brittany Carroll, and we just thank them for this beautiful arrangement, and it will help us to remember and think about Adrienne all day today. So thank you, Brittany and Gina, for these.
Of a place. place I love even more than I usually do. And although I know it's a long road back, I promise you.
Say the word home, especially at Christmas time, and memories of special family traditions spring to mind. But whether it's gathering round to read the Bible on Christmas Eve or inviting 50 people for Christmas breakfast, it's a sure thing that you will have some memory that begins with the words, "That was the Christmas when." That was the Christmas when the little popper wouldn't pop out of the turkey until Norman finally pried it loose with a screwdriver. That was the Christmas when Delaney got those inline skates and broke her ankle on them Christmas afternoon. That was the Christmas when my little boy locked us all in the basement family room after dinner and wouldn't let us out. Our fondest memories may involve singing the carols that signal the start of the Christmas season. Celebrating with those songs is one tradition we could trace back for many generations.
Father, a blessed angel came, and unto certain shepherds sing we now Noel. Sing we now
Grandma's house, small and far from luxurious, but the two brothers had wonderful memories of playing there while they were growing up. Now, through a series of complicated incidents, it had been sold, and their aging grandmother was forced to live in little more than a shack. The brothers pooled their resources, bought back the newly remodeled cottage in the Tennessee hills, and presented it to their grandmother as a Christmas surprise. She would never again have to worry about where she would live. Instead, she was coming back home to a place that had been transformed by their love for her. God sees us hurting, needy, weak, and unworthy. He has bought us back by sacrificing His only Son. He transforms us on the inside. Then, wonder of wonders, God Himself comes to make His home with us.
Tears are falling, hearts are breaking. How we need to hear from God. You've been promised, we've been waiting. Welcome, holy child. Welcome, holy child.
So many of our Christmas memories are entwined with songs like Silent Night and Joy to the World. It's amazing to think that just two chapters in the Gospel of Matthew and 2 in the book of Luke are all the facts we really have about the events surrounding the birth of Jesus. In our trying to imagine what it must have been like that night, thousands of songs and stories and sermons have been written. We just want to know the look of the stable, the sound of the angels, the excitement in the air. It's the reason there will always be something more to say about how Jesus left heaven, became human, and made this his home for a while. The shepherds knew he was something special. A choir of angels had announced his birth. The wise men knew it too. A star like no other they had ever seen led them and shone down on him like a spotlight. Mary and Joseph knew better than anyone that the baby they held in the stable was like no other child ever born. God himself was here. The song that rolled across the hills outside of Bethlehem that night was only the first of the songs about his birth that are still being written today.
Shepherds on the ground are afraid of them.
Home for Christmas sounds good, doesn't it? But realistically, lots of people don't get there for one reason or another. Maybe it's because of a commitment to some noble cause or an obligation that just can't be passed off to someone else. Maybe it's a financial impossibility, the death of someone dear, or a tear in the fabric of love that usually holds families together. This year, maybe there's an empty place at your table and in your heart that's making it hard to remember how the words home and Christmas used to bring you so much joy.
Soldier bows his head, facing loneliness and fear, maybe even death. Home seems far away tonight, as freedom he defends. He prays for peace and then he breathes, let Christmas come again.
If you're longing to feel truly at home for Christmas, the best place to start is in God's love and grace and His plan for your life. It's the place where you're always certain to find hope and joy and peace. It's the place you're always invited, eagerly expected and most welcome. His heart is ready to receive you, and he's watching for your safe arrival. He waits to hear you say, "You'll be home for Christmas this year." Say the word home this Christmas and be reminded that Bethlehem's child was the promised Messiah whose coming brought joy to the world. Today, when we sing about him, we not only look back, we look forward to the wonderful day when Jesus will come again.
Yeah.
Well, thank you. Just remain standing. Thank you for being here this morning and for your presence today, and from the choir and from all of the folks who are the staff of Providence Baptist Church, we wish our membership and our church family a very Merry Christmas and a very happy New Year season. In just a moment, we're going to have a dismissal prayer. I want you to go directly out to the flagpole. Please stay on the sidewalk. We won't be there but just a minute. Bring your order of service with you because it has your program in it that will do for the burial of our time capsule, except this morning it'll be simulated burial of the time capsule. But we'll look for you out there. Will you bow with us as we pray together? Oh God, we just thank you so much this morning for this opportunity to come to your house. We thank you for the music that you give us in our hearts and in our voices, that we can raise our voices in song and praise and adoration to you. We just thank you so much for Sean and for Lara and all that they give and do to help us. And Lord, we just pray your blessings upon them. We pray, oh God, now that you will take us from this place and keep us safe until that time and appointed time and when we gather together again in your name. We pray this in Jesus' name and for his sake. Amen. Amen. Before you go, let me just say thank you to Sean and Lara for the hard work they do to help us to pull this out of us. So we thank Sean and Lara.